Good morning students and hello everyone. Today we will do some sums of the chapter. The chapter is height and distance. This is the application of trigonometric ratio. In your board book, open your page number 327, sum number 20. First I read the sum and everybody follow me and see in your book. Number 20, Amita Didi standing on a railway overbridge of 5√3 meter height, observed the engine of the train from one side of the bridge at an angle of depression of 30 degree. But just after 2 seconds, she observed the engine at an angle of depression of 45 degree from the other side of the bridge. Let us find the speed of the train in meters per second. Again I read. Amita Didi standing on a railway overbridge of 5√3 meter height. The height of the railway bridge is 5√3 meter. Observe the engine of the train from one side of the bridge at an angle of depression 30 degree. But just after 2 seconds she observed the engine at an angle of depression of 45 degree from the other side of the bridge. Let us find the speed of the train in meter per second. Let us draw the figure of this sum. Sum number 20. Sum number 20. Let us draw the figure. Now this is the horizontal line. This is the horizontal line. Now this is the bridge of the height of the bridge. This is the height of the bridge. This is the bridge. At first, Amita Didi see this distance is 5√3. AB be the height of the bridge. The angle of depression of the engine of the train from the one side of the bridge at an angle of depression is 30 degree. Now this is the angle of depression is 30 degree. Is the angle of depression. This is the angle of depression. This is 30 degree. Just after 2 seconds, she observed the angle of depression is 45 degree from the other side of the bridge. So this is the other side of the bridge. Just after 2 seconds, the angle of depression is 45 degree. This angle is 45 degree. Now this is the engine E1 and this is the engine E2. E1, E2. Now this angle is 30 degree. So this and these are alternate angles. So therefore this angle is also 30 degree. And measurement of this angle is also 45 degree. And height of the bridge is 5√3 meter given. So AB equals to 5√3 meter. AB equals to 5√3 meter. E1, E2, this is a distance. This distance cover in a time 2 seconds. So now calculate the speed of the train in meter per second. Let AB be the height of the bridge. So therefore AB equals to 500√3 meter. E1 and E2 E1 and E2 are the position of engine such that A is the Amita Didi. In the point A, Amita Didi is here, such that angle AE1B equals to 30 degree and angle AE2B equals to 45 degree. Very good. So now there are two right angle triangle. From right angle triangle ABE1, now we calculate the total distance E1 and E2. Now E1 E2 equals to E1B plus BE2. So now we calculate E1B and BE2. So from right and AB is given, calculate it. So therefore this by this, from right angle triangle ABE1, E1B by divided by AB. According to this angle, E1B is a base and AB is a perpendicular. Base by perpendicular. What trigonometry ratio? Base by perpendicular.
Cot theta.
This is the cot. Yes, cot 30 degree. E1B by AB, this is the cot 30 degree, which implies E1B divided by AB. AB is given 5 root 3. Now this is equal to value of cot 30. Anyone? Value of cot 30?
Root 3.
Very good. Which implies E1B is equal to 5 root 3 into root 3. 5 root 3 into root 3 is 15. So E1B is 15 meter. Again, from right angle triangle ABE2 is a right angle triangle. Gaurav is waiting, not allowed. Again from right angle triangle ABE2. Now we calculate BE2. BE2 divided by AB. This is equals to, according to this angle, according to 45 degree angle, BE2 is a base and AB is perpendicular. So base by perpendicular, same trigonometric ratio, cot theta. So here theta is 45 degree. So this is now cot 45, which implies BE2 equals to value of cot 45 1, and this is equals to AB. AB equals to 5 root 3. AB equals to 5 root 3. Cot 45 1, so BE2 equals to 5 root 3. Now the value of root 3, okay. So therefore
1.72.
Okay, I put just later I put 5 value of root 3. Now therefore E1 E2 is E1B plus BE2. Now E1B is 15 plus 5 root 3. Now we common 5 root 3 is common. So 1 plus
root 3.
So E1 E2 is 5 root 3 into 1 plus root 3. Now we calculate the speed of the train meter per second. So this distance covered in 2 seconds. So therefore, just this 15 plus 5 root 3. So therefore, speed of the train is distance by time. So 15 plus 5 root 3 by 2 meter per second. So now this is 15 plus 5, value of root 3. Value of root 3, 1.732 divided by 2 meter per second. Calculate this, 5 into 1.732. Now calculate.
Sir, 11.83
meter per second. 11.83 meter per second. 11.83 meter per second. Quick copy this. 21. I read the sum. A bridge is situated at right angle to the bank of the river. If one moves away a certain distance from the bridge along this side of the river, the other end of the bridge is seen at an angle of 45 degrees. If someone moves further distance of 400 meters in the same direction, the other end is seen at an angle of 30 degrees. Let us find the length of the bridge. So let us draw the figure of this problem. At first we draw a river. This is not a geography class, but also I draw a river. In geography class, the bank of the river is a curved line, but in mathematics class, the bank of the river is a straight line. Now we draw a bridge. So this is the parallel. Now this is the bridge. AB is a bridge. A man moves this, and angle of the other end of the bridge is 30 degrees. So therefore angle is 30 degree. Angle is 30 degree. A bridge is situated at a right angle to the bank of a river. If one moves away a certain distance from the bridge along this side of the river, then the other end of the bridge seen at an angle of 45 degrees. So sorry, this angle is 45 degrees. This angle is 45 degrees. And if someone moves a further distance of 400 meters, of more 400 meters, so therefore this distance is 400 meters. Now this is the C and this is the D. Now CD distance is 400 meters. And from D, the angle of the other end is 30 degree. This angle is 30 degree. This angle is 30 degree. Let us find the length of the bridge. AB is the length of the bridge. Let length of the bridge, length of the bridge B AB. Angle ACB, angle ACB equals to 45 degree, CD equals to 400 meter, and angle ADB is 30 degree, equal to 30 degree. Let BC equals to X meter. Let BC equals to X meter. So therefore, BD equals to write BC plus CD. BC is X and CD is 400. Now this is X plus 400. This is the BD. From right angle triangle, form right angle triangle ABD. ABD is a right angle triangle. According to this angle ADB, this angle, measurement of this angle is 30 degree. AB is a perpendicular and BD is a, sorry, at first we write from right angle triangle ABC. ABC, AB by BC. According to this angle, AB is a perpendicular, BC is a base. We know perpendicular by base is tan theta. So tan 45 degree, which implies AB, BC, BC is X, AB by X equals to 1, which implies AB equals to X. Okay. AB equals to X. Any question? AB equals to X. Again, from right angle triangle ABD, again from right angle triangle ABD, AB by BD. AB is perpendicular, BD is base. So this is tan theta. Here theta is 30 degree. So therefore tan 30 degree. Now here AB is X, X by BD. BD is X plus 400. X plus 400 equals to tan 30. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So root 3x minus x, root 3x equals to x plus 400, which implies x, root 3x minus x, this is equal to 400, which implies x is common, root 3 minus 1 equals to 400, which implies x is equal to 400 by root 3 minus 1. Now 400 by root 3 minus 1, root 3 plus 1 is the conjugate sides. So numerator and denominator multiplied by root 3 plus 1. So root 3 minus 1 into root 3 plus 1, this is a plus b into a minus b. Root 3 square minus 1 square, root 3 square means 3, 3 minus 1 means 2. So 400, so this is equal to from there. So this is equals to x equals to 400 by 3 minus 1 into root 3 plus 1. So now this is equal to 200 into root 3 plus 1. This is the x. Now x means the length of the bridge is AB. Here AB equals to x. So therefore length of the bridge, right now answer here, therefore length of the bridge, length of the bridge is 200 root 3 plus 1 meter. This is the length of the bridge. This is the answer. Here the value of root 3 is not given. So I cannot put the value of root 3. This is the answer, 200 into root 3 plus 1. Number 23. I read the sum. If the angle of depression of two consecutive milestone, correction of the book, consecutive, not milestone, consecutive kilometer stone, right? Mile replaced by kilometer. On a road from an aeroplane are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. Consecutive kilometer stones means the distance between 2 kilometer stone. Now this is the kilometer stone and this is the kilometer stone. These two are two consecutive kilometer stones. So therefore, distance between two stone is 1 kilometer. This is the meaning. Sixty degree and 30 degree respectively, the angle of depression of two consecutive milestone on a road from an airplane are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. Let us find the height of the airplane. Number one, when two milestones stand on opposite side of the airplane, this is the first sum. 2 kilometer stone stand on opposite side of the airplane. And sum number two, when two milestones stand on the same side of the airplane. So this is first we do 23-1. 2 kilometer stone stand on opposite side of the airplane. At first we draw a road. This is a road. This is the aeroplane. In this sum, 2 kilometer stone stand on the opposite side of the aeroplane. So this is A and B. A and B are 2 kilometer stone, and distance of AB is 1 kilometer. Distance of AB is 1 kilometer. Now C is aeroplane and CD is the height of the aeroplane. The angle of depression 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. The 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. So this angle is 60 degree. This is the first stone. And 60 degree, right? 30. And this is 30 degree. This is the angle of depression. In this case, height of the aeroplane. Height of the aeroplane. Let CD be the height of the aeroplane. A and B are two consecutive consecutive kilometer stone. And angle, this angle is also 60 degree, alternate angle. And this angle is also 30 degree, they are alternate angle. And angle CAD is 60 degree and angle CBD equal to 30 degree. From right angle triangle, from right angle triangle, let AD equals to X kilometer. So therefore BD equals to total AB distance is 1 kilometer. If AD equals to X kilometer, then BD equals to 1 minus X kilometer. let AD equals to x kilometer. So therefore BD equals to 1 minus x kilometer, because the total distance AB is 1 kilometer. So BD is 1 minus x kilometer. From right angle triangle ADC, ADC is right angle triangle, ADC is right angle triangle, ADC is right angle triangle, CD by AD, now CD is the perpendicular, AD is a base, CD is perpendicular, AD is base, perpendicular by base is tan theta, now this is tan 60 degree, which implies CD equals to AD, value of AD, AD is x and tan 60 is root 3. Now CD equals to x root 3, call it number 1. Again from right angle triangle BDC, again from right angle triangle BDC, CD by BD. Now this triangle CD is perpendicular, BD is base, perpendicular by base, tan theta, theta is 30 degree, this is tan 30 degree, which implies CD equals to BD, BD is 1 minus x by tan 30 is 1 by root 3, 1 minus x by root 3, call it number 2. Now comparing 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, the left hand sides of 1 and 2 are CD, so therefore right hand sides are same, so therefore x root 3 equals to 1 minus x by root 3. X root 3 equals to 1 minus x by root 3. It implies 3x equals to 1 minus x, which implies 4x is equal to 1, which implies x is equal to 1 by 4. X equals to 1 by 4. Now we calculate the height of the aeroplane. Height of the aeroplane is CD. So therefore height of the aeroplane CD, CD is x root 3. So therefore height of the aeroplane is x root 3 kilometer. Now value of x, 1 by 4 into root 3 kilometer. We know 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meter. So now 1000 root 3 by 4 meter, 1000 by 4, this is 250 root 3. So in this case, that is sum number 1, the height of the aeroplane, right answer, height of the aeroplane is 250 root 3 meter. 250 root 3 meter. Quick copy the sum. Case, two stones stand on the same side of the aeroplane. Now this is the road. This is the road. This is the height of the aeroplane. The angle of depression 60 degree and 30 degree. So this is the first stone. This angle is 60 degree and this is 30 degree. So this angle is 60 degree. So therefore this is 60 and this angle is 30. This is 30 degree. CD, height of the aeroplane, A and B are 2 kilometer stone. Let AD equals to x kilometer. So therefore AD is A. So therefore BD equals to total AB is A and B are 2 consecutive kilometers stone. So length of AB is 1 kilometer. So length of BD is 1 plus X kilometer. BD is 1 plus X. From right angle triangle ADC, CD by AD, CD is perpendicular, AD is base, is tan theta tan 60, which implies CD by AD, AD is X, so CD equals to AX root 3. Number 1, CD equals to AD X root 3. From right angle triangle, BDC, CD by BD, CD is perpendicular, BD is base. So this is tan 30 degree, which implies CD and BD is 1 plus X is equal to tan 30 is 1 by root 3, which implies CD equals to 1 plus X by root 3. Number 2, comparing 1 and 2, x root 3 equals to 1 plus x by root 3. Now x root 3 into root 3, this is 3x equals to 1 plus x, 3x minus x, 2x, 2x is equal to 1, implies x is equal to 1 by 2. So therefore, height of the aeroplane is CD. CD is x root 3. X root 3, value of x is 1 by 2 root 3 kilometer. So this is the height of the aeroplane, root 3 by 2 kilometer. Now you put 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meter. 1000 by 2 into root 3 meter. Now this is 500 root 3 meter. In sum number 2, the height of the aeroplane is 500 root 3 meter. Right answer in separate sentence. The height of the aeroplane is 500 root 3 meter. Okay? Thank you. Copy the sentence quickly. Any question? Any question? No question. Okay, sum number 22, homework 22 and MCQ question, very short answer type, 24 and 25 short answer type question, fill in the blanks, true false, MCQ and sum number 22. These are the homework. Next Thursday I will take another class. Okay, thank you.